was gonna post one of these sooner, but decided against it. Helps to open that. Okay, so I'm in my little desert base. This is the downstairs portion. Oh, you freaking thing. It's been doing that to me lately. Alright. Not here. Oh, freaking Enderman. I wonder where he is. Jim. Yes, sound like one of those things on Star Wars. Okay. So anyways, between the last time I recorded and this one, I explored and went across the ocean south of the basically directly south of where the whole island and everything that we're on is. And are you? Oh, there you are. Okay, let's see. Please drop an ender pearl. What? Score. Okay. Yeah, because I found one of the best ways to take on Enderman is to go into a space that's only tall enough for you to get into, because it has to be 3 blocks high for them to get into it. I found a bunch of coal and silver and everything over in this desert. But yeah, that's... Oh, I'm stuck. Alright, so I built a little mini house. There used to be steps, but I took those down. And just put in ladders because it was taking up too much space. This was my initial garden, and then after I built the portal, I built this one above this. So it's got like a nice little greenhouse look. So right now I'm in a place that's mostly all desert. Put in the sugarcane stuff here. And I have trekked from one end of this desert the other, and this one's actually a small enough island that I can pretty much do it in one day versus some of the other areas I've been to, where it would take me a couple of days just to go across it. Oh, it wasn't these guys. But, so that I can find my way back, I made a bunch of those towers. Where are you? Baby zombie. So yeah, making those were fun. The first couple of ones I tried to make sure I made them close to. Got it. Ow! Where'd that come from? So the first couple ones, like that one there, I tried to make sure that I built it next to water so that when I came down from there I could just jump in water, but there were a few of them that were basically in the middle of a dune or something, so I had to just wing it. I partially went here hoping to... hoping to find villagers because, got like 40 something emeralds. And about one of the only good things those emeralds are really good for is, trading with villagers. And I haven't seen any villagers. Anyways, I built this portal, to the nether. My initial plot with that was to try to find a quicker way back home than going across the freaking water. So, because it was quite a ways. Main path. Yeah, path to main portal. Follow torches. And there's a similar sign down there for it, too. I had to build this because, one, you don't want the portal to be destroyed while you're here. It's just, it's a really bad idea. Even though it's made out of obsidian, if you don't have a, flint and steel with you, it's kind of hard to restart it. And right away, as soon as I got here, I was hearing ghast all around. And then, every time I go to explore a little, or I step out, very far, or I would start, trying to make these tunnels, I would come back and there would be a ghast hovering over it. Even though the place looks enclosed, they would still get in and tend to hover right over the base. So while trying to avoid one, I built this. And then that helps me go directly to this. Then, like I said, follow the torches. Let me see if I can speed run. I tried to make a slightly more direct path, but it wasn't working. I kept running into dead ends. So. I did block off some things here and there so that I would know. Ah, that giggling. Jeez. Okay. It's a fairly quick way to the main portal. And then the main portal takes me to the main house. There's actually another portal that goes into a cave. And I put that over by the fortress. And when I found out I could get out of the cave, I found out it mostly put me underwater. The cave runs under the ocean. I put a slight blocker there and saying desert portal that way. Main portal's this way on the other side. So, desert portal. There's just another long tunnel down that way. Dangerous. Why did I run a little bit faster? compressing gas in this area too, and I thought they couldn't get into this particular area, or that they just wouldn't float into this area, and then they did. So. What the hell are you all doing here? Okay, the nether wart hasn't grown enough. Been in enough. And this was open, but I decided to close it because the more I was shooting at blazes, the more they were getting closer. Oh! Turkey. That's the fortress down there. It goes off that way, a little bit into there some. Goes over to there. It pretty much stops. There are a few things that go off that way. This can still be extended and things. I just put that so that, you know, I wouldn't have blazes and gas going after me, because there is actually like that bridge ends right there, and then that stuff's almost connected. I mean, it's like within a hair's breadth. So oh, come on, come on, come on. Let me in. Just let me in. I stuck the other port here. Closing off a couple of these areas. They, and then if I take this waterfall up, I wonder if I can. I don't know if I should. It looks like it might be night right now. Close to it. Yeah. Anyways, there's familiar stuff up there that I passed one time when I was, boating around, trying to find stuff. And then there's another door that leads into another set of caves over here. I haven't really checked out the land deal over at, one very much well, because I already went there once by boat, and once was enough because the island was freaking huge. It was more than an island, it was a whole continent, and it took me days and it took me a long time just to get out of there. And it's pretty much got all the same landscape and resources and everything that the current place that our main base is at has. So I just haven't really bothered with it. It has resources, but other than that, I'm like, eh, okay. Down some bridges, and now I'm able to be back home. Yay! I didn't have to cross the water again and get myself lost. Okay, and everything regrew. That's good. You need 12 altogether. I ended up making a bunch of water potions, healing potions, and fire resistant potions, and these are the ones that will last for 8 minutes. And the better healing, and I extended the water breathing to 8 minutes. These are just water bottles right now. I haven't done anything with them yet. For a lot of the potions, you have to put nether wart in first, make an awkward potion, then like with the potion of fire resistance, I have to put in a magma cream, let it go through, then in order to extend it, I have to put in redstone. But if I'm doing like, well, these healing potions, I have to make a glistening melon, which is, you know, these little nuggets around a melon. Then combine that with an awkward potion. So you have to do the awkward potion first, then you have to do the, put the glistening melon in there, let it go, and then in order to make that one stronger, you have to use glowstone dust rather than redstone. And for a lot of the stuff, redstone is what you use to extend it, but for making that one, that particular one stronger, you use glowstone. Let me see. Yeah, I added that in there. I think I used, I used the gas tier on regeneration. You have to be very careful when you're doing that one, or else you screw up the potion and you waste a gas tier. I tried to fill in these off-screen, but the maps I made aren't matching up, and they should have. And I believe when I made these, I did, I only expanded it like one time or something, but I think it's saying I expanded it twice. I'm not sure, and but it doesn't quite add up like this. No, that should be the top one. This one was the one I did first. And that one should be here. And it's not connecting right there. So I have to figure out what I did. So I'm just leaving these on the side. I can't really... They don't let you, like, you know, wipe and clean and remake them. Once they're made, they're pretty much just made. And so... They match up fine amongst themselves, but they don't match up with this one, which is a real pain in my butt because, you know, I need them to match up. Okay, like I said, I have 49 of these. I want to find a village sooner or later. I mean, the villagers are idiots and mostly kind of pain in the butt, but now, I'd like to be able to do something with emeralds, and I think trading ones are really one of the only things you can do unless you guys want to use them decorative. So, I guess I'm still in search for a village. and I looked all over that that desert. I found a fountain that was pre-made, like a well, but it was the only thing. There wasn't any. Any villages or anything nearby? And I said, I'll get that one. What? How? Where? I mean, this in there. This there. Zombie flesh. Actually, if you collect a lot of that zombie flesh, that's actually tradable too. I mean, you can use it to live off of if you're desperate. But, I got to the habit of keeping the zombie flesh because a lot of times the clerics in the villages, they want it for some reason. I don't know why, but they do. Yeah, I got a lot of redstone when I was carving up that tunnel. So I ended up just making a whole bunch of it. The best way to mix that 64 with this is just to do this. Because it takes that many bricks to make deals. Otherwise, it'll only make 16 out of one stack. Unlike these, where if you have 64 in a stack, it'll make 64. So, yeah, I still have potatoes and everything. That's good. Okay, so the zombie spawner is basically down here. I probably should make a path connecting it. There's actually another room over here that goes into a cave. I haven't really explored it yet. I haven't really wanted to at the moment. And this was kind of working. The spawner's basically right under here. And I left down a lot of the ladders that I used in order to make it, just in case if I need to tweak it. But, my problem with some of it is that occasionally I'll be standing here waiting for them, and I think, one, there probably could have been a way that I would have made it a little bit quicker. Two, occasionally I'll be waiting here for them, and I'll hear them dying long before they get here. And I don't know what's causing that. Where that's happening. Come on, we're working before. Yeah, because see, normally they should have already been here by now. And there you go. So I have no idea where they're dying at when they do that. And I started getting them to where, you know, they would get in there. And they'd end up, you know, dropping down. I just don't entirely know what the problem is, though. used a specific pattern. Wondering if they're not going up the deal right, because one deal says to use signs in order to make the deal, rather than other deals to say you can use ladders. So I didn't worry about it when I ran out of signs at one point, because I forgot to take a bunch back here with me, and I had a ton of ladders, so I just put ladders up it instead. And they worked a little different, but they still had pretty much the same effect for, you know, all intents and purposes. So I was like, okay, you know, it seems like it'll work, no problem. I'm actually wondering if I screwed that up a little bit. As you can see, a few are landing, but it takes them forever. And, like I said, there's ones that are dying on the way, so I don't know why they're dying. That's not supposed to be happening. Right now, I only have this little opening in case it makes baby zombies, because I heard one. They're getting killed in the deal that's going up. And that ain't good, but redoing it so that they don't get killed can be a real pain in my butt. End up with invisible horses and boats and everything. Uh oh. Well. Just splash me with a potion. Turkey! Yeah, as you can see, it's just desert, and, you know, trees, and plenty of this acacia wood. I got a bunch of saplings and took them back, but, as you can see, there's like, okay, let me see, the spire. Whoa. Okay. And then as soon as I got to a certain distance where that one started to fade, I made another one. I said I made that one close to the water so I could just jump down in the water. But then I made this one. And dry land, because as soon as that one started to fade, this one needed to be made, and I kind of wanted to do it close to the water, but at the same time, it seemed a little bit too close. And I did these so that I'd be able to find my way back when I went, you know, out and about exploring, and so far they've been really helpful. No matter what direction I go in, as soon as I find these, I'm able to find my way back to the main house, so... Oh, hey. One of the things I will show. This thing that occurred naturally, with no village around it. So I stuck some torches around it. Oh, you eat a chicken. This is one of the only things I've found. I'm saying kind of like, oh, come on, I usually only find these around, you know, villages. I'm wondering if there's something down below this. I'm not 100% sure. So far it's looking like that's a big fat no. And now I got a bunch of sand in my inventory. Oh well. That's actually one of the smaller ones I made. I was kind of running out of stone at the time, and I didn't want to make it very big since I'd have to jump down off of it. Yeah, move it, bunnies. Ah, you're too small for me to shoot. This one I fell down before I got done completing it. You can see where the torch got ended up. Be one. Oh, I think I forgot to make the last one. I got turned around and ended up not making it. Okay, well. Okay, that one's still very much visible. Oh. Okay, there is one. I just can't see it from over there. I can see that one. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna make a midway one. Okay, put this down so I don't fall off again. This one. There we go. So yeah, I think I'm gonna leave it here because I'm not exactly sure where to go or what to do yet. Now that I've done the nether deal. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the moment. So when I figure out what I'll do next, I'll let you know. Bye bye.